When you think about where the world is heading these days, it really is like we are on a voyage to somewhere that nobody knows the destination to, and the seas are getting very, very choppy these days. Now, when we talk about technology and innovation in the world, a lot of people jump right to talking about one thing when it comes to that ship. They start talking about the engine room. We hear all about the tools and the technologies and the hardware that are powering that voyage, but we never hear anything about where the ship is actually going. We never actually talk about the passengers on that ship, and we never really talk about why we're sailing in the first place. So today, I'm going to tell you about the engine room. We're going to talk about the hardware, don't get me wrong, but I'm also going to tell you a little bit about that ship, because ultimately, I think technology isn't just the study of machines or software or new innovations. It's about the effects of those innovations on societies. It's about what people do with that technology and how it changes lives and communities and businesses and actually has an impact in the real world, not just in the lab. You consider the groups and the civil society organizations that have grown online. There are now more than 1 billion people who are just in Facebook groups who actively use them. You consider the fact that you can get a vantage point on the Milky Way from the International Space Station at the click of a button. You can look inside a refugee camp in Africa. You have this incredibly global perspective. And in the global brain, you also have this volume of content that is growing exponentially. You may all remember the ice bucket challenge. That was that extraordinarily annoying summer in 2014 when we were all very, very happy to give our money to a very, very worthy cause. But really, you don't want to have to keep throwing buckets of ice water over your head because your friend from third grade challenged you to a fight. But anyway, this thing was amazing because about 10 million videos were posted and watched by about 440 million people, and it ended up raising, in just a few weeks, more than $120 million to fight ALS just in the United States alone. And when you think of ALS, most people never thought of ALS. They had never even thought about contributing a dollar, and federal funding to fight that had been very, very limited. And this was a huge infusion of cash towards actually reaching a cure, hopefully, in our lifetimes. And action at scale becomes systems and institutions and networks, the most powerful permanent forms of change that we can create. This is a picture of the most advanced machine on planet Earth right now. This is the Large Hadron Collider. It is an absolute marvel. I've been to see it in person, and it is absolutely monumental. But this is the world's largest particle collider. It is buried under the Franco-Swiss border. And this machine is literally unraveling the secrets about our universe, trying to solve the most fundamental questions unknown to scientists about the state of physics. And so the only way we've been able to actually make this machine work is, again, through the internet. There are 170 different academic and research centers in 42 countries that are all linked together through the internet, which are crunching that data together. And all of those things are basically slowly churning their way through this data and will hopefully unravel some amazing insights into the way our universe functions. So what comes next? We have that global brain. We have that global community. What's coming in the engine room? Why should we be excited about what the internet is delivering us? Surely there's something more. Well, there is, and these are what I call 100x advances. The Hyperloop is the other concept you may have heard about. Hyperloop is a concept that has been popularized by Elon in just the last few years. It is a proposal to use a vacuum tube, essentially, to transport pods down these pressurized tubes at about 760 miles per hour. Now, if we can actually end up with a form of transportation that fast, you will absolutely redefine how cities are organized. You will be able to get from Las Vegas to Los Angeles downtown in 30 minutes using the Hyperloop. Self-driving cars are going to not become just a novelty or something for rich folks in Silicon Valley to play with on their tech campuses. They will be rolled out all over the world. And by the way, every single CEO of every single major automobile company in Europe and the United States has predicted at the utmost, in the most conservative estimates, that self-driving cars will be on the road and legal by 2025. That is literally just a moment away. The immediate applications of AI are much more pedestrian, but just as exciting and valuable in our ordinary everyday lives. You may use Netflix. How many people here have Netflix? Yeah, all right, pretty much everyone. Every time you use Netflix, you are experiencing AI. Those recommendations that Netflix generates on your home screen, that is the result of an incredibly powerful artificial intelligence that Netflix has spent billions of dollars investing in. It learns your habits and your tastes based on all sorts of different markers, and it basically trains this incredibly powerful artificial personality version of you to tell you what you might like next. My closing message, the future, in spite of all those trends, in spite of all those learnings for our organizations, it will still be crazier than anything I can imagine, anything you can imagine. So we need to be open-minded about what comes next.